Hello everybody, my name is Mr. Raz. I am SAP Basis NetWeaver International Trainer. I have trained students and helped people in more than 50 countries. Punarvasi Technologies is my company. And www.punarvasi.com is my website where I used to write different step-by-step procedures on SAP basis administration. And this is the website homepage. Punarvasi.com is the site, and SAP basis training videos is my video space, that is basis videos. You can watch some demo videos from my YouTube channel. You can click on this YouTube channel to go to the YouTube channel where you will find some free demo videos. In this video, I will explain how to install EHP 7 for SAP ERP 6.0. It is enhancement pack 7 and IDES installation, means sample company data will be available within this system. Means the functional people SD, MM, PP, FICO, HR, many more functional people can use the sample data for their practice. It should be used for learning purpose. Let us proceed to next slide. How do you install ECC 6.0 EHP 7 software? Can be installed directly on your server which has server operating system. If you don't have the server, you have a laptop or desktop computer with client operating system, that is Windows 7 or Windows 8, you can install this particular software, that is ECC 6.0 EHP 7 IDES within VMware workstation. Because this ECC 6.0 EHP 7 IDES needs server operating system, instead of installing on your laptop client operating system, you have to install VMware workstation in your client. Then within the VMware workstation, you have to install Windows Server 2008 operating system. Or do you have a computer with server OS? For suppose if you have a desktop computer in which you have installed Windows Server 2008 operating system, you can install ECC 6.0 EHP 7 IDES directly. VT, virtualization technology. To install this ECC software within your laptop or desktop which has client operating system, should have BIOS, the VT option, virtualization technology option, and this particular option should be enabled to run virtual machine within VMware workstation. If you don't have this option, VMware workstation cannot be installed and you cannot run Windows Server operating system within VMware workstation. No VT option, you can install ECC 6.0 EHP 7 IDES directly, provided that if you can install Windows Server operating system on your laptop or desktop computer. Hardware requirements. You need to have 64-bit processor, for example i5 or i7 or AMD processors, 4 GB RAM for direct installation, or 8 GB RAM for VMware installation. If you install on top of VMware, you can allocate 4 GB from this to VMware workstation. Means you need to have 4 GB RAM for your host operating system also. For suppose if you are installing on top of Windows 7, Windows 7 should have 4 GB RAM, and 4 GB should be allocated to VMware. And 400 GB or more HDD free space, and you should have another 200 GB or 150 GB for storing installation files and to extract the RAR files. You can install ECC 6.0 AHP 7 IDAS in a single drive, that is C:\drive, or you can also have multiple partitions, but you can install within single drive. You can create another drive for installation files, that is software dump. Means if you want to store the software installation files in separate drive, you can create another drive within the VMware, or if it is a physical computer, you can have the partitions. So what are all the softwares required to perform this particular installation? You need to have Oracle software and IDAS SAP ERP 6.0 EHP 7 installation exports. This is the major folder, and the size of this particular folder also use. And Oracle client software is required, and SAP kernel is required. SWPM, that is software provisioning manager. You will start the installation from this particular directory only. I'll show you how to extract the files within this directory. And VMware Workstation 9 if you are performing the installation within VMware Workstation. And SAP GUI for Windows, after completion of the installation of ERP 6.0 HP 7, you have to install SAP GUI for Windows to access SAP system. And then you need to have the J2 SDK software that should be installed as prerequisites for installing ECC software. And Microsoft Windows Server operating system DVD, that is either ISO file or bootable DVD. If you are performing direct installation, you need to have the bootable DVD, or if you are performing within VMware workstation, you can have ISO file. And the folder screenshot I have provided here. These are all the whatever the folder names I have given in previous slide. So same thing is here. And folder size before extraction. Before extraction, the folder size is around 65 GB. And you have to perform the VMware workstation installation before starting Windows Server 2008 operating system installation. If you are performing installation on top of client operating system, that is Windows 7 or Windows 8, you have to install VMware workstation for installing on top of your existing client operating system, that is example Windows 7 or 8. If you have server, if you can install Windows Server on it, there is no need to perform this step. There is no need to install VMware workstation. You can proceed all the remaining steps by treating as you are installing on a direct computer. I have installed this software within VMware workstation, so that you will see VMware within the next screens. Don't confuse between both types of installations. Creating, once VMware workstation is installed, you have to create the new virtual machine within VMware workstation 9. So this is the screenshot for creating new virtual machine. You have to run the VMware workstation from your program files. Once you run the VMware workstation program will be opened, and from there you have to click on the file and then new virtual machine. You have to click on the new virtual machine. you will see the screen that is welcome to new virtual mission wizard. Here you have to choose the custom option. Instead of typical, you have to choose the custom option and you have to click on the next button. And you have to choose the hardware compatibility, that is workstation 9.0. If you are installing this particular software on top of Windows 8, you need to install VMware Workstation 10. It will be available in internet. You can download and install VMware Workstation 10.0. And you have to choose the operating system, guest operating system installation. Out of these three options, you have to choose, I will install the operating system later. Means you can also select these two options, but you have to provide the ISO file here itself. It will ask you the CD key of the Windows Server operating system. The ISO file which I am providing, which I have, doesn't need any installation key. So that's why I am choosing third option. So click on the next button. And this is the Microsoft Windows Server 2008 x64. You have to choose this Microsoft Windows and you have to select from this drop down Windows Server 2008 x64 and click on the next button. You need to name your virtual machine, that is EHP7IDS. I have named it as, and the total installation will goes into C drive, that is C:\US users ras documents virtual machines EHP7IDS. And be careful that your C drive should have minimum 400 GB free space to install this particular software. Better to have 500 GB for this particular installation. You will have some free space for working purpose. So I recommend to have 500 GB here. Click on the next button. And you have to choose the number of processors and number of cores per processor. If you have quad core processor, you can choose number of processors as 2 and number of cores per processor 2. And normally one is enough. I have performed this installation by choosing 1 and 1, and click on the next button. And you have to choose the RAM here, 4 GB RAM I have allocated. I have actually 32 GB RAM on this particular computer. Even though I have 32 GB RAM, I have chosen only 4 GB for this particular installation. If you have 8 GB RAM in your computer, you leave 4 GB RAM for your host operating system. 4 GB you have to specify here for this particular virtual machine installation. And click on the next button. Then you have to choose the use bridged networking. The networking is most important part while installation of this ECC software within the VMware workstation, because without networking, the server operating system will not perform properly for ECC software. Means you can't start Oracle TNS listener, Oracle software cannot be run. So that you need to use proper networking. So if you choose use bridged networking, what it will do is it will use the host operating system network and it will take the IP address from your router automatically. If you don't have the router or the internet connection, once you configure this new virtual machine and once you install Windows operating system, you can install Microsoft Loopback adapter so that it will work as standalone. Normally most of the people will have the internet connection by default, so that there is no need to install Microsoft Loopback adapter. Choose use bridged networking and click on the next button. And accept the default of LSI Logic SaaS recommended in this screen. Click on the next button. And select a disk, create a new virtual disk. You have to choose the first option and click on the next button. And we are going to create new virtual disk, and the default disk type is KSI recommended. Click on the next button. And here I have chosen 500 GB as free space. If you don't have the 500 GB on your C drive also, you can choose the 500 GB. The file size will grow automatically. And better you
keep 500 GB in your C drive so that the VMDK file will be stored within the C drive, will grow automatically up to 500 GB. And store virtual disk as a single file, means the file will be stored as a single file. If you don't select this option, what it will do is split virtual disk into multiple files. Instead of multiple files, just choose this option. And don't select this allocate all disk space now. If you select it, what it will do is it will allocate total 500 GB now itself. Click on the next button. And the file name is ehp7idas.vmdk. Whatever the name we have selected for new virtual machine, with that name the VMDK file will be taken. And click on the next button. And this is the summary screen, ehp7idas. Location is SQL and users RAS documents, virtual machines, ehp7idas. Click on the finish button. After you click finish in the above screen, you will see the entry ehp7idas in the left pane of VMware workstation as shown in the following screen. There are lot of VMs in the left pane. Ignore all and look at ehp7idas. I have selected ehp7idas so that right side you can see the settings of selected VM, that is ehp7idas. Before power on this virtual machine, you have to choose the Microsoft Windows Server 2008 ISO file by selecting CD or DVD option in the right side pane. Let us see. So this is the, once the new virtual machine has been created, you will see this option here, ehp7idas, and other systems you can see here. You ignore all these systems, you just see this particular system, ehp7idas. Whatever you select related to that particular system, the options will be displayed here. Power on this virtual machine. Before clicking on this particular option, you have to choose CD or DVD option to provide the ISO file of Windows Server 2008 x64. So once you choose that CD or DVD option, you will see this type of screen. Choose that CD or DVD option and use ISO image file. Click on the browse button. Go to the folder I have shown in the previous screens, and the Microsoft Server Windows Server 2008 ISO file will be located. Once you choose this ISO file, click on the OK button to proceed further. And once you select the CD or DVD option, you have to click on the power on this virtual machine. Once you click on this power on this virtual machine, it will go to the screen like this. Windows is loading files, and just wait for some time, you will see this type of screen. Accept the default and click on the next button. And click on the install now button, and you will see two types of options here: Windows Server 2008 Enterprise 32-bit x86 and Windows Server 2008 Enterprise 64-bit x64. You have to choose the second option, don't forget it, because SAP ECC software can be installed only on top of 64-bit operating systems, I mean latest ECC software. And accept the license terms, click on the next button and click on the custom advanced option. And 500 GB we have allocated, and free space is 500 GB. Just select the disk and click on the next button. Means it is actually not formatting the actual hard drive, just it is formatting only the virtual disk, that is .vmdk file. And the file size of the .vmdk file also will be very low. in starting, and as and when you are installing some softwares within that, the file size of will size will grow. The file size will grow. Click on the next button and it will start copying files, and after some time the Windows Server installation will be completed. You will see this particular screen and click on the exit button here. There is no need to install any other extra third party softwares. Just click on the exit button and you will see this type of screen, that is the user's password must be changed before logging on the first time. Click on the OK button so that it will ask you to enter the new password. You provide the new password here and repeat the password. Click on the enter button and your password has been changed. The Windows Server 2008 Enterprise is ready to go. Click on the OK button and initially you will see this screen, that is initial configuration tasks. You no need to do any configuration tasks here. Select this option, do not show this Windows at logon, and click on the close button. And then another screen you will see, that is server manager, and here also there is no need to do any management of the server. Just select this do not show me this console at logon, means it this particular screen also will not be displayed whenever you switch on your virtual machine. Click on the close button and the select network location, and you can choose the work location. Click on the work, and so that the network connection, that is choose this for a workplace or similar location, your computer is discoverable and you can see other computers and devices. Means if any other computers are connected within your network, you can see those computers with from your VMware workstation. Click on the work. Okay, and once it is done, click on the close button. And I have maximized the screen by clicked on the maximize button within the VMware workstation so that it will show like this, and click on the I finished installing button within the VMware workstation. Once you click on the I finished installation, it will show like this. Means you have chosen the third option, that is choose I will uninstall operating system later. That's why that message is there. So that's why anyway I have it already installed Windows Server operating system. That's why I have clicked on I finished installing. And first time what you have to do is you have to click on the install VMware tools. So once you install VMware tools, what it will do is it will adjust all the configuration settings so that your mouse cursor will work perfectly within the VMware virtual machine. Means the mouse movement and network functionality will work fine, so that you click on the install VMware tools. And also you can maximize, you will see full screen within the window once you perform this particular installation. Click on the run setup and welcome to the installation wizard for VMware tools. Click on the next button and click on the next button. Click on the install button and the VMware tools will be installed within the virtual machine. Click on the finish button and click on the S button to restart it. So once it is restarted, again you will see this type of screen. So this control alt delete option is shown here. If you press from your keyboard the control alt delete, what it will do is it will your host operating system will take that command. So that what you can do, you can click on the VM and click on the send control alt delete option from here, so that the action will be performed within the virtual machine. Or if you want to use your keyboard only to do this particular function, you have to enter control alt insert within the virtual machine. You have to click inside this particular window to perform that. So anyway, I am clicking here so that it will show like this, and click on the finish fit guest now. Click on the fit guest now so that the entire screen will be displayed. Guest will be displayed. The guest will be adjusted with the full screen. So once you come to the screen, just right click on the computer, click on the properties. Click on the properties so that you will see the screen, and click on the advanced system settings, and you will see this particular screen. From here, you have to change the computer name of your virtual machine. Click on the computer name. So once you click on the computer name, the full computer name is showing like this, means the computer name automatically taken by the installer. So you have to change it. Click on the change button and change the computer name to EHP7IDAS, and click on the more button to provide the DNS primary suffix, that is punarvasi.com. I have provided here. You can put your own domain name, whatever it is. There is no need to have the live domain name, whatever you have, that is something dot something. Okay, click on the OK button. It is called fully qualified domain name. ehp7idas.punarvasi.com is called fully qualified domain name, and whatever the computer name you provide here, that does not exceed 13 characters. There is a restriction for SAP installations. You need to have the characters maximum up to 13. Click on the OK button, and the following error occurred validating the name EHP7IDAS. A duplicate, potentially the shorter NetBIOS name, exists on the network. You should choose a different name for this computer. So maybe within my network the same name is being used, that's why it is giving this message. Otherwise it will just go fine. Click on the OK button, and you must restart your computer to apply these changes. Click on the OK button and click on the restart now so that the system will be restarted. Okay, once the system is restarted, just click on the VM and click on the settings button, and you will see this particular option. And once you get this option, click on the add button. And what I'm doing is I'm just adding another hard drive for storing all installation files within the VM, that is virtual machine, for performing the installation. Means I don't want to use the C drive for storing all the files, because the C drive will have final installation. Later you can copy the .vmdk file to safer location for reuse of that particular .vmdk, and the software does not need to be there once the installation is completed, so that the dump of the installation files will be stored in the separate hard drive. So within the VMware, you can add any number of hard drives virtually, and select the hard disk, click on the next button, and use an existing virtual disk. Instead of use an existing virtual disk, just click on the create a new virtual disk, means it is separate disk, another disk I am going to create. Click on the next button and SKC, click on the next button, and here maximum disk size is 100 GB. I have chosen 100 GB, means this particular .vmdk file will have only the installation files. And store virtual disk as a single file, click on the next button, and ehp7idas dump.vmdk file, this particular name I have provided here, and all the software extracted files will goes to this particular .vmdk file. Means later you can use this particular .vmdk file for reinstallation purpose whenever you want. There is no need to extract the files again and again to perform the installation. Click on the finish button. So once it is done, the hard drive, previous hard drive is 500 GB, that is actual software will be installed within this particular disk, and the software installation files will goes into this particular disk. Click on the OK button. So once it is done, you have to manage the disk by right clicking on the computer and click on the manage button. And once you go to the manage button, click on the storage, you expand the storage, and after expansion of storage, select the disk management, and in the disk management, this is the disk one, and in the disk one, just right click here and click on the online button, so that the disk one will become online. So once it is online, you have to again right click on the disk one, click on the initialize disk, means the disk will be initialized, and click on the initialize disk, and the disk one will be displayed like this, and click on the OK button. And once it is done, the basic is now online. And in the simple volume, right click and click on the new simple volume, and welcome to the new simple volume wizard will be displayed. Click on the next button and accept the defaults. Click next button and assign the following drive letter: E drive. C drive is already allocated to the 500 GB hard drive, and D drive is default to the CD drive, and E drive will be for this. Click on the next button and format this volume with the following settings, that is NTFS file system. Click on the next button, perform a quick format, select this particular option, click on the next button, click on the finish and format the disk. It is by default it will be formatted, there is no need to format again, just click on the cancel button, and within the computer you will see this particular E drive. It is 99.9 GB, free space is completely it is available, and double click on it and create a folder within this E drive by right clicking here and click on the new and folder, and EHP7IDAS dump means I am going to extract all the files required for further installation into this particular folder, and click on the double click here and create related folders within this particular folder, and go to next screen and go to VM and click on the settings, means all the files are located in my host computer. I have to extract from my host computer to the virtual machine. Click on the settings, means I have to share the folder from the host to this guest. It is VM, virtual machine is called as guest. So click on the settings and go to the options. Once you get this screen, click on the options and select shared files, and always enabled. Map as a network drive in Windows guest, means within the Windows guest it will be mapped as a network drive. Select this option and click on the add button, and this wizard will be started. Click on the next button, and host path is f:swdump. I have stored all the RAR files within this EHP7IDAS folder, and starting I have shown you the screenshot of the folder, and name of this particular folder is EHP7IDAS. Click on the next button and enable this share, and it is read only, means nothing should be corrupted within the host operating system. That's why I have selected only read only, means you can use that particular files for read purpose, not for writing purpose. Click on the finish button, click on the OK, and now you should be able to see this particular shared folders: VMware host z:, and double click on z:, and so once you double click on the z:, you will just go to this particular folder, that is IDAS SAP ERP 6.0 EHP7 installation export. These are all the major files, means total 3 GB into almost all 14 files are there. 14 into 3 means almost above 40 GB. So alone this particular folder size is very huge. You should be very careful in extracting these files. You have to double click on the first file, that is exe file. Once you double click on it, remaining all the parts will be taken by the installer automatically, and it will extract the folder to wherever you select. Just click on the double click here. So once you double click on it, you will see this particular screen, and click on the run button, and destination folder it is showing by default within the z drive. Only z drive I have chosen it as read only, it will not be extracted into the z drive. You have to click on the browse and set the path within the virtual machine, that is E drive EHP7IDAS dump and / IE installation exports. Export files will goes into this particular directory. click on the install button, and it will take some time. It will be extracted within the E drive. Okay, once it is done, and you have to copy this Oracle client, right click here and click on the copy button, and go to the EHP 7 IDAS dump within the E drive and click on the paste button, paste option to paste the Oracle client within the virtual machine. In the same way, you have to copy all the, like this kernel file is in the zip format. You have to extract, click on the extract all, and you have to provide the E drive path, that is /EHP7IDAS-dump-kernel. Click on the extract button and files will be extracted within the kernel folder of /EHP7IDAS-dump. And SWPM folder also, just click on the copy and paste within the EHP7IDAS-dump. Like that, you have to copy here, or you can directly install the Java J2 SDK from here only, but for safe side, what I am doing is I am copying all the software within the virtual machine. There is no need to copy actually here. Just double click on this particular file to perform the J2 SDK installation directly. So click on the copy and paste it into this particular folder. In the same way, Oracle software, that is 5104234. If it is already extracted within your host operating system, directly you can perform the Oracle installation also from the network drive itself. But in this case, what I am doing is I am just extracting the files to virtual machine. Just double click on the first file to extract the files, and again you will see this type of screen. Click on the run button and chosen /EHP7IDAS-dump/Oracle. Click on the install button so that the Oracle folder will be created within the /EHP7IDAS-dump. So what I did finally is that I have copied everything within the EHP7IDAS-dump. So once you have all these files ready, you can start the installation. Means the prerequisites for installing ECC software, you have to first install the J2 SDK software. So I have double clicked on this particular file. Once I double click, you get this particular screen. Accept the terms in the license agreement. Click on the next button and just click on the next. All the default options, that is C:/J2 SDK, default folder is this, and remember this folder, we will use this particular folder to set the Java home in the environment variables. Click on the next button, click on the finish button. Now you see within the C drive, J2 SDK 1.4.2_22x64, just right click on this particular folder and click on the copy address, so that the address of this particular folder will be copied to your mouse clipboard, and go to computer, right click, click on the properties and click on the advanced system settings, go to advanced and click on the environment variables. Here click on the new button under user variables for administrator, and you will see this particular blank screen like this, and you have to fill the blank screen with these values, that is java_home, and here variable value control V means whatever the folder you have already copied within your mouse clipboard, that will be pasted here, and click on the OK button so that the previous screen will be displayed like this. And you have to choose the path option from the system variables, select the path and click on the edit button, so the path and edit the variable will be shown like this, and hit home button from the keyboard to come to the front of this particular value, and right click and paste here, because the C:/J2 SDK is already available here, and put slash and type bin and put semicolon here. So this is the setting of the path of the J2 SDK, that is exe files. So click on the OK button and click on the OK button. So instead of clicking on the OK button, what I will do is I'll set the performance settings also. Click on the settings option to get the performance options, and choose the option called adjust for burst performance. Means for installing ECC software, you need to have the best performance. That's why you choose the adjust for best performance, and click on the advanced tab and click on the change button to set the virtual memory setting, and choose the C drive option. And here you will see automatically manage paging file size for all drives. Tick mark, checkbox is ticked. Just remove that option, remove that tick, and choose the custom size and type 25,000, means default you need to have the 20 GB for installing SAP software. So for safe side, 25 GB I have chosen here. Initial size 25 GB, maximum size 30 GB. And once you type these values, click on the set button, click on the OK button, and you will see total paging file size for all drives here, 25,000 MB. Click on the apply and it will be closed. Apply and OK, it will be closed. And now the J2 SDK is installed and configured, environment variables are set, and virtual memory has been configured. All prerequisites are done, and now ready to install the database software, that is Oracle database software. You have to go to the E drive, EHP 7 IDAS dump, and Oracle folder 5104234 database, and SAP folder. Within this SAP folder, you will see SAP server.cmd command. Double click on that particular file to run the Windows batch file. You will see the screen, and by default it will ask for the drive letter where to install the Oracle software. If you have two drives, that is C:D:, you can choose the D:. Also, if you have more space in the D drive, you can choose the D drive. In this case, only C drive is there. Just click, hit enter, so that it will take the C drive. And in the next screen, you choose the SID, that is system identifier, consists of three alphanumeric characters starting with a letter. This is Oracle software as system identifier. By default, you should have one system identifier for installing Oracle software, and hit enter. This is the initial screen will be displayed. The Oracle Database 11G Release 2 Installer, installing database step 1 of 11. It is just straightforward. Click on the next, click on the S, and here skip software updates. There is no need to have any updates of the software. Click on the next. And install database software only the database software will be installed. There is no need to it will not create the database by default, because the SAP system will create its own database within this Oracle software. So install database software only, click on the next button. And single instance database installation, it is a single instance database installation, it is also default value. Click on the next button. And the default selector language is English. Accept the default and click on the next button. And it is enterprise edition, it is also default value. Click on the next button. And by default, the Oracle base is C:\Oracle. Software location is C:\Oracle/dev/11203. Click on the next button. And checking physical memory, all prerequisite checks it will do. And click on the, once you get the summary screen, click on the next button. And this is the summary screen, click on the install button. And you have to wait for some time until it completes the installation. And so the final screen looks like this, and click on the close button. The installation of Oracle database was successful. The Oracle software is installed perfectly on this particular machine. Now the actual ECC software installation should be started. The ECC software will be installed using the software provisioning manager, the SWPM directory. I have shown earlier this particular directory in the screenshot of the folder of all installation files. You have to double click on that particular folder, that is SWPM. Within that particular folder, you will see two files like this, SAP car underscore, this is the SAP car for uncover the files, that is SAR files. So this is actually the installation master. Okay, the size of this particular file is 522 MB. Click on just you see this particular folder and right click on the SWPM and click on the copy address and go to command prompt. Go to command prompt and put cd space and right click here anywhere in the blank, like a black screen, and click on the paste button, paste option here to get that particular folder whatever you copied in the earlier screen, that is /ehp7idas.dump/swpm. Once you pasted here, hit enter so that it will display like this. And to see whether it went into the /, or not, just type /, and hit enter from your keyboard so that it will display the entire folder like this, /ehp7idas.dump/swpm. Okay, here you have to execute the command. Just dir, type dir and see those two files will be displayed here like this, sap car file, swpm here, and s, type sap and hit tab from your keyboard so that it will display entire file name like this, sap car i_315-so-and-so, and put space here and type hyphen, that is dash xvf space, and again sw type and hit tab from your keyboard so that entire file will be displayed like this. Once you get this command here, hit enter from your keyboard so that the extraction will be started. So extraction will be started and it will extract it to the same folder like this. All the folders will come here like this. And here you will see this SAP inst exe file. You have to double click on this particular file to start the ECC installation. Double click on it. So you will see this particular screen. From here you have to choose SAP Business Suite 7i 2013 support release 1, means it is the latest one, and you have to choose EHP7 for SAP ERP 6.0 ABAP support release 1, and choose the option Oracle. Under Oracle, SAP systems, application server ABAP, and standard system, and click on the next button. If you want to install any other software like EHP3 for SAP CRM 7.0 ABAP support release 1, you can choose this particular option, but you should have the export files related to CRM, and in the same way the SCM software, SRM software, whatever the. Once you choose this option, click on the next button and typical custom, choose the typical, it is a default option. Click on the next option, next button, and first time it will log off. Click on the OK button to log off and enter the password here and hit enter so that the installation will be started automatically and it will come to this particular screen. It will ask you to enter the SAP system ID, that is SAP SID. You have to provide this particular system identifier, DEV I have provided. You can choose other system identifier also here. It is SAP SID, and the DEV we have selected while installation of Oracle, that is different and this is different. But for easy simplicity, I am using the same DEV here, and the destination drive is C:. And click on the next button, and it will ask you the folder of kernel, and wherever, whatever the folders you have extracted, you have to use those particular folders, and click on the browse and choose the particular related folder here, /ehp7idas.dump/kernel. Click on the next button, provide the password for the master password. This is the same password will be used for logging into the SAP system, and this is for the master password for the SAP administrator and SAP service username. And click on the next button here, and database ID. Earlier SAP SID, here DB SID. You can choose different also here, and but for simplicity I have used the DEV only here. And SAP SID and DB SID are different. You can give different SIDs for SAP SID and DB SID. You can distinguish between these two SIDs using this particular concept, that is DB SID, that is SAP SID. So SAP, it is SAP SID. Sorry. So this is SAP SID, it is DB SID. So once you provide DEV here, click on the next button and it will ask you to provide the installation export 1 ECC 6.0 HP 7 SR 1, and you have to choose the particular folder here, /EHP7IDAS-DUMP-IE folder. You will have two folders within this particular IE directory. You have to choose the first folder, click on the next button. I have expanded here, just you see 5104831 2_1, it is installation export 1. Click on the next button, and the second folder also it will ask, that is installation export 2 ECC 6.0 EHP 7 SR 1. You have to select the second option. Click on the next button, accept all the defaults here, and click on the next button. And here you will have E drive, something is there. So you have to choose all C drive, because I am performing the installation within the C drive itself. So click on the next button, and this is the listener information, don't change any values here. Click on the next button, and RDBMS client Oracle, Oracle folder, Oracle client folder should be selected here by clicking on the browse button. Click on the next button, and install diagnostics agent is not required. Click on the next button. And this is the final summary screen. From here you can choose any of the options and click on the revise button to change the values, whatever the values you have selected during this phase of installation. And once you satisfy with all the values you have chosen, click on the next button to start the installation. Once you click on this next button, it will take approximately more than 12 hours, means in my case approximately it took 15 to 16 hours around with 4 GB RAM. Click on the next button to start the installation. It will go up to this stage very fast. Within half an hour's time it will go to this particular stage. From here it will take most of the time, means 14 to 15 hours time will be taken at this particular stage. Import above, there are 164 steps, means import should be done, means that is IE installation export folder, whatever the 40 GB files are there, it will be utilized in this step. And completed 63, I have took some screenshots while performing this installation. Completed 63, completed 76, completed 120, and completed 162. And after that, this import above phase will be forwarded to next steps. So like this, perform Oracle post load activities. After this import above also, it will take something around 1 to 2 hours time. And perform Oracle post load activities and creating database directory statistics and create database statistics. It will take some time. Click on the next. No need to provide any next, just for your understanding purpose I took all the screenshots while installation. And finally it will start the instance and executing ABAP reports. It will execute some reports here, and finally this is the successfully completed screen, that is execution of SAP Business Suite 7i2013 support release 1, EHP 7 for SAP ERP 6.0 ABAP support release 1, Oracle, SAP systems, application server ABAP, standard system, whatever you have chosen while starting this installation will be shown here, has completed. And perform initial system configuration task in an automated way by using the ABAP task manager for lifecycle management automation. For more information, see these notes. And once you this successful message, click on the OK button to close this particular screen. and the ECC main software installation is completed, you can start the SAP GUI for Windows software within this VMware virtual machine, or you can install this particular software within your host operating system also. From host operating system also you can access the SAP system. Okay, just right click here, this is the SAP GUI for Windows file, right click here and click on the extract all, and the files will be extracted within the GUI folder of this particular folder /ehp7idas.dump. Click on the extract, and once it is extracted, go to that particular folder, that is ehp7idas.dump GUI NW70 presentation plus 1 GUI Windows Win32. Double click on setup all and the SAP GUI for Windows installation will be started. It is called SAP Frontend Installer. Click on the next button and select all, click on the next, and it will by default it will goes to this particular folder C:\Program Files SAP Frontend. Click on the next button C:\Program Files SAP Business Explorer, and this is the default folder for Business Explorer. Click on the next button. The installation of SAP frontend components completed successfully. Click on the close button. So once it is completed on the desktop, you will see this type of logo, that is icon. Double click on that icon to open the SAP logon 730, and it is blank, nothing is there, and choose the connections, and in the screen right click. Right click and click on the add new entry, and you will see this type of screen. Click on the next button and provide all these details, that is EHP 7 for ERP 6.0. You can choose your own name, whatever you want, and this application server, it must be computer name which you have selected while installation, and the instance number by default first installation will take as instance number is 00, and the system identifier, that is SAP system identifier DEV, whatever you chosen, you have to provide that, and click on the finish, and this in this way the entry will be displayed. Double click on this particular entry to log on to the SAP system. Once you double click on it, the SAP initial logon screen will be displayed. Welcome to IDAS ECC 6.0 including EHP 7, and type the client number, that is 800, user is ID admin, and the password is IDES. This is the default user account for the IDAS systems. So once you provide the details, username and password, you will see this particular copyright screen. Once you hit enter, you will see the SAP easy access screen. So this is the final screen, means successfully logged into the SAP ECC software. So ECC 6.0 EHP 7 IDAS installation successfully completed. I hope you understood the concept of installation, SAP software installation. Almost all the SAP softwares will be installed in the same procedure. So once you understand the concept of this installation, you can perform any type of SAP software installations. So this is my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, and this is my channel, that is www.sapbasis.tv. I am Mr. Raj, SAP Basis Network Trainer. You can become my private list of subscribers to watch all the current 101 videos and future videos, if any, at free of cost. I am providing this subscription at $149 per year only. I hope you will join with me to learn greatest technology. Means once you pay $149, whatever the current videos are there, you can watch all those videos, and during this year, whatever the videos I'll record, you can watch them at free of cost within this particular price. And once the entire year completed, next year will be charged again $149. Thank you for watching this video.